None of us have been able to escape the dreadful images of Ebola's impact in countries such as Liberia. Our efforts have been challenged, but our will and our determination are stronger than ever. Because of the generosity of people like you over the past years, Change Agent Network has achieved the following successes. Over $1.7 million raised in 8 years to impart the lives of tens of thousands of people, including women and children, all across the world. Continued construction on 3 of the 7 established community schools, or hubs, in Liberia to bring real hope and opportunity to impoverished people of the world. The ongoing construction of the Change Agent Network University in Northern Liberia. We believe in higher education for all. The project will be completed by 2017. Completed 3 guest houses across Liberia to host visiting volunteers and missionaries, as well as to locally generate profits to help financially sustain the community school or center. Built 3 worship centers around the country in Liberia to provide a special place for prayer, praise and worship, and community meetings for locals as well as brothers and sisters from abroad. Provided clean, running water to 3 school communities, the first clean water system ever experienced by the people in these communities. Water is life, and water has no enemy.
Almost 1,000 students in this school, and also a growing community of almost 20,000 persons.
Wow.
And are going to benefit from this kind of equipment and facility here. It's the first of its kind in this community, in this whole entire area, the first technology of this kind.
Ships 10 40-foot containers of medical supplies, educational materials, computers, and other items of basic necessities to Liberia and supply them to the schools and communities that we have jointly built across the country. Provided agricultural tools and seeds in a Pay It Forward program conducted by Yasa's sister to over 110 women in remote jungle villages in Lofa County, Northern Liberia. One who develops a woman builds a nation.
Hi, I'm Fran Clark. I've been a psychotherapist in Lafayette, Louisiana for 25 years. And even though much of my work has focused on helping women to feel a sense of strength and personal power, I would never have considered myself an activist. The video, Pray the Devil Back to Hell, told the story of how one woman met with the people of the Christian and Muslim churches, bringing those churches together for the first time ever. And that woman stood up and called for the women of Liberia to put an end to the war. The women came together by the thousands, and they devised a scheme so that they could trick the warlords into meeting, and there they held them captive for 6 weeks. The women sat in the rain and in the heat, and they sang and they prayed and they chanted until the warlords sound a peace accord. When I saw the story of those women, it humbled me and it inspired me, and I knew that I had a lot to learn from those women. And I thought that maybe there was a way that I could be of help as well. So I followed the example of the women, and I called together women in my own community. From those very humble beginnings, we began Yasa's Sisters. With $700, we were able to provide axes, hoes, machetes, and seeds to 25 women in a very remote jungle village in Liberia. Those women produced two farms of peanuts, and from those farms of peanuts, they expanded to other women. When we visited in 2012, there were now 110 women, 10 men, and several villages that were participating in the program. But things are very tough for those women. In order to get their produce out to market, they have to walk for 2.5 days with the produce on their heads through the jungles. So part of what we need to do is be able to help those women to create regional marketplaces that'll serve the villages that are surrounding them. We also need to help them build a storage shed so that they can store and process the things from the market. When we were there, the chief gave us 15 additional acres to develop. We have plans to build a school and a clinic, and also to help them to reestablish the cultural and artistic things that were lost during that war. Ebola also took a tremendous toll on our women. They've been unable to farm because of the risk of contracting Ebola. One of the goals of Change Agent Network is changing minds, hearts, and lives. And Yasa Sisters and Change Agent Network changes those minds, hearts, and lives, not just in foreign countries, but in the people that are participating from the U.S. as well. Personally, my life has been greatly enriched by participation in Yasa Sisters. It's broadened my perspective beyond anything I ever could have imagined. It's opened my heart. It's helped me to realize that everyone can be an agent of change for good in the world. It's also helped me to realize that what I do and what I don't do makes a tremendous difference in the lives of others. I have met incredible people, amazing, courageous, inspiring women. And I've also realized that any time we're involved in an activity with Change Agent Network, there is a huge energy of love, and that's what I want in my life.
Graduated over 100 kindergarten children from the elementary division of two of our high schools in Liberia. Information leads to transformation, providing them with quality Christian education to assist them in developing independent minds. Built and donated 7 houses to homeless families residing in the communities in which we live and serve in Liberia. These homes provide protection to impoverished children and families who slept on dirt floors. Thanks to you, they now have real roofs over their head.
So, it's beautiful, Eva. It's beautiful. I hope that you like it.
Any call for you?
So I know I have anything that hacking in a brother here, the hacking in Moravia. And when I saw you as a brother to me, I said, Papa, I'm here, I honor the ring. You told me, say, I will even look for people to help you to cut the water for the lotion that will carry you. I said, Papa, when you do that one for me, God will bless you. I am expecting for you to cut water for me. For God said the water will be summer for you. The water now tend to mash up for me. So I appreciate whatsoever that God has given you the power to do it for me. Because through you, then God back you before today. You moving for honor the ring. I tell you thank you, and I tell God thank you.
Anticipating the graduation of 200 students from the 842 Computer Technology School later this year, 2015. Training and equipping them for the labor market of Liberia so that they may become useful and productive citizens of the world. financially supported two of our young emerging leaders through university. These are young people who have been serving their community sacrificially for over 11 years. We currently have an additional 7 young people who are being supported in various universities in the country. Our program has over 200 employees across the country on payroll, creating financial and job opportunities for them to be able to provide for themselves, their families, and the community. Over 100 people from around the U.S. and other nations traveled to Liberia on mission and volunteer trips over the years to positively impact the lives of the suffering Liberian people.
The adults interact with each other differently. The children come to school even when it's not school hours. And I believe that this will be the center of, God willing, a movement that could transform the whole country. I do know that this school will bring hope to this community, that children will learn, that they will learn to be self-sustaining, that they will develop small businesses that will support the school and support their families, and I'm going to be a part of it.
Educating over 3,000 children in just 2 of the schools we are operating in, with 5 additional schools in the works. These schools develop the poor by offering education to help them become meaningful contributors of their communities, their society, and their world. Expanded our scope of involvement by establishing collaborative partnerships with other service organizations in countries such as Sierra Leone and Ghana.
Students at Houston Elementary are trying to help feed kids in West Africa.
It's a project to show children they can make a significant change in a community far away. KY3's Dustin Hodges joins us, and Dustin, they're doing this by collecting change.
That's right, Maria. The program is called Change for Change. The kids bring in their spare change. That change is then collected in jars that are in every classroom and used to buy bricks at 50 cents a piece to build a cafeteria at a school in Liberia, West Africa. The students have found creative ways to come up with the extra change, even going door to door to collect it. They say it's opened their eyes to how much different life is for children in some countries.
Well, we have like food, how much food we have, and they barely have any food over there, so we're trying to help them so they can eat more.
We tell the kids they can bring in anywhere from a penny to $5 or whatever, just as long as they're bringing in money, so that way they understand that their contribution helps someone besides themselves. They're bringing in this money to help these kids in a whole nother country.
Sometimes I've tried to get like do some chores at home so I could get some money to bring, and then my birthday came, so I bring birthday money, and so I just try to get as much change as I can.
Taking several medical doctors to Liberia from the U.S. to help save lives and provide important health services and education to the local people in the various communities that we work in. Thank you so much for the wonderful work that you have done for the struggling people of Liberia. We hope you have been able to see, touch, and experience the real impact of your valuable contributions and services to Liberia. Be very proud of what we have all been able to accomplish together thus far. We are very grateful, and may God continue to bless the good works of your hands.